by souls. Muslims used to convert Hindus by force. Why did they do that? Did they want Hindus to work in their farms after conversion? Or did they want them as their servants? No. Muslims had believed that in Quran Sharif, Surat Furqani 25, it is mentioned in entire Quran Sharif, the knowledge giver of Quran tells, those who worship others except Allah are spoiling their life. Those who worship others except Allah are spoiling their life. Therefore, Muslims' followers thought that these Hindus are innocent and ignorant. They are ruining their lives. If they are converted, it will be for their well-being. So they started converting Hindus to Islam, considering them as brothers. Muslims had misconceptions that they worshipped that Allahu Akbar, who created entire universe in 6 days and sat on throne on seventh day. He is complete God, and actually, he is. But this was their misconception. Their intention to convert them to Islam was just like if the younger brother or sister doesn't take a tablet, then the elder forcibly somehow makes them to drink it forcibly by holding their mouths, make him to drink. He may or may not cry for a while, but his illness will be cured. So, similarly, they started converting Hindus to Muslims because they worship other except Allah, other deities, other gods who can neither provide them gains nor can harm them. This was their purpose, nothing else. It wasn't to increase population. But Muslims will now come to know that they are also worshipping others and not Allahu Akbar. They also have misconception. This slave has the worship of that Allahu Akbar, complete God, Paramakshar Brahm's worship, which will provide complete salvation. Come and get it. Now I will show you with the pious religious books of two religions, it is proved that God is in man form, he is like humans. Like you read in Srimad Bhagavat Gita, chapter number 4, verse number 32, the knowledge about various religious rituals. Yajna means religious ceremonies that has been mentioned till Gita, chapter number 25, verse number 30, that is, one worships in some way, someone worships deities, one reads holy books, one does penance, someone fasts, one does yoga. They all consider these practices to be superior. But the actual knowledge is what that complete God has given through his nectar words in detail that God himself has told, that is true spiritual knowledge. Ask that correct spiritual path from an enlightened saint. Same is mentioned in Quran Sharif, that ask from an enlightened saint about that Allahu Akbar, about that great God. Yajurved clarifies that some consider God as Samvat, some call him a Samvat, that is, some say that he takes birth and comes as Sri Ram and Krishna, some say he never takes birth. An enlightened saint will give this information, listen from him. So this is that enlightened saint, by souls. This is the golden chance for you, if you understand.